YouTube, Rook here from Rook Geek Goodness, my little channel web for all things geeky and cool, and welcome back to the channel, guys. Welcome back to a brand new Funko review. In this particular video, I'm really, really happy to showcase this brand new pop for you. Of course, we're talking about the return of Boba Fett, where he actually returned in Mandalorian Season 2. Spoilers, if you're not familiar with Mandalorian Season 2, Boba Fett indeed came back supporting a new look, new deco, new feel for the character. And I think maybe down the road, I might do a redux, if you will, of an evolution video, which I did about a few years ago to show the character's progression through time, how it changed, and how he evolved. And this is the latest, greatest look for Boba Fett now in the Star Wars universe and Star Wars canon. And we're going to do a full breakdown segment. Speaking of breakdown segments, we're going to start the breakdown right now. And when we start a breakdown segment, the very first thing we do is look at the packaging and presentation. This, of course, is your standard Funko design box. And there's one key important piece that we have to talk about in the packaging, because it really showcases on the back of the packaging, which will make sense momentarily. So if we look at the packaging here, we have, of course, pops up here at the top. We get the Star Wars logo, which I think may be where the problem lies. Pop number 462, a great window box display of Boba Fett that you can see right here. Nice shot of him right here. Does a Boba Fett across the bottom. Over here, we have a look at what the character looks like out of packaging, and you have Pop and Boba Fett across the bottom. Over here, we do have the Boba Fett words on the side, and the back of the packaging showcases all the characters that be available in this particular way. But the important part that I was talking about was right here, the Mandalorian. Why did not put Mandalorian across the top here? Kind of weird approach for Funko. I don't know why they did that. If they did characters based on a Mandalorian wave, they normally would put down Mandalorian across the top. It wouldn't say Star Wars. Yet we have it on the back of the packaging. Really, really weird choice Funko has done in this sort of approach. Let's take a 360 on the platform here on my my turntable, so you can see what it looks like in 360. Really like what they did with this character. This, of course, is a change of direction for Funko. We normally don't see Boba Fett look like this, and it'll make a lot more sense when I take him out of the package momentarily. They change the look and feel of Boba Fett to kind of make it reminiscent for the Mandalorian TV show, and I really like what they did with the character here, because it really shows the growth and change of Funko looking from the prior designs of Boba Fett to where he looks now. They completely revamped, redesigned him, redid the buck, and the deco looks completely, really different. I'm very excited with Funko's change of direction for Boba Fett. So that being said, guys, let's get Boba Fett out of packaging and continue the breakdown segment. All right, guys, continuing our breakdown segment, we have our Boba Fett from the Mandalorian TV show Season 2 out of packaging. And next thing we do, take a pop out of packaging, is we look at the paint and articulation. First things first, there is no articulation for this pop. It is a bobblehead. All Marvel pops and Star Wars pops, because of licensing restrictions, must be bobbleheads. And I'm not a big fan of bobbleheads. I've talked about it before. But because of the licensing restrictions, they have to make them bobbleheads. So there's no real quote-unquote articulation. There is a spring, of course, right here, that if you move the spring a little bit, you get the head to move a little bit for you. But all things considered, with that kind of negative point, because it is a bobblehead, off the table, this is a phenomenal pop. I love what Funko did, taking basically the cues from the Mandalorian TV show and incorporating them for this particular pop. Let's take a look at the deco first, the head sculpt. Awesome head sculpt. You look at this, you know it's Boba Fett. There's tons of battle damage. You can see the chrome, the wear and tear, the chrome coming through here off his helmet. It just seemed like better days. You could tell there's a lot of just damage, just wear and tear, weathering on it. It looks awesome. I love what they did with this particular pop. Love it, the head sculpt. The viewfinder, of course, does not articulate. This is still stuck in the top position. He's used this before in the TV show, where this would go down over his eyes and it'd be a range finder, so you can see where the target is and lock on them with his missile backpack. That's the idea. But all in all, it looks really, really good. I love the weathering, the attention to detail, the battle damage. He's wearing this kind of different little skirt, this black skirt here going across his legs. Looks really, really cool. I love, again, attention to detail. The weathering just looks awesome. The back right here, you can see the helmet right there. All the battle damage, how it's scuffed up. It looks awesome. He is sporting a blaster. You can see it right here in his hand. I love the attention to detail for the blaster. It looks really, really cool. There is deco on it. There is sculpt for it, so you can see that they paid some attention detail to the weapon. It looks really, really good. Of course, the backpack that he has right there, the missile backpack, looks great. I love what they did with this particular character. Looks awesome. Now, what I want to do is bring in one of the very first Boba Fetts they came out with to give you a comparison to what he looks like then and now. And this is just really, really cool to showcase off what he looked like now compared to what he looked like back in the day. And this is where I'm getting at, where having the Evolution 2.0 video may come into play. Because you can see then to now, it's a huge difference. The deco looks different. The presentation, completely different. You know both characters are Boba Fett, but you could just see a huge change in the design and philosophy for Funko. I love what they did with this particular sculpt, showing it from now to then. It looks really, really awesome. I love what they did. Of course, this version of Boba Fett does come off the pegs. That was the older design where you can remove him from the figure stand. He is locked down. You can't remove it. It does have the Star Wars base, I didn't mention that before, with the white text that we know from most Star Wars pops support that. Both, of course, have the rangefinder. But you can see the change in design and deco in the buck, the way it looked, compared to what it looks like now. And I really like what they did here. And you can see the growth of the character. That's the whole point of making in this portion of the breakdown segment. So taking the old Boba Fett away and really focusing on this guy here. Again, the one thing I didn't touch base on was this belt he has, a sort of gold belt. In the actual show, if you lift the skirt up, you would see these knee pads, which are small little missile launchers on either knee, I believe he has. And it's really cool. It's a different sort of weapon system for Boba Fett. We haven't really seen that before. I wish you could have maybe seen the knee pad, but he does have a little holster. I didn't mention that either. Sculpted in where he put his blaster, the flamethrower attachment right here, or wrist grabber. I think it's a lasso he has on this one as well, both a flamethrower and a lasso launcher on this arm, I believe, or I think it's on that one because there's nothing present on this arm here. But all things considered, absolutely love this particular version of the brand new design, reimagining the Boba Fett from the Mandalorian Season 2 TV show. Would I purchase this in a final thought? Absolutely. If you're a fan of Boba Fett, absolutely. Because look, as again, coming from where he was to where he is now, a huge redesign for Boba Fett. Absolutely, if you're a fan of Star Wars, fan of Boba Fett, you can get this pop pretty much anywhere. It's a common pop. I got it at a SuperCon 2021. I believe the price for this guy was $20. He's not an exclusive. He's not a chase. He should be easier to find out in the wild right now, but I highly recommend getting Boba Fett from the Mandalorian TV show Season 2. I do hope you like this video review of Boba Fett. Remember to give this video a like at the bottom page and click that subscribe button, picture my face, that circle. When you click subscribe button, click the bell, kind of be notified of my latest videos. And of course, last but not least, you can click windows over here to watch more of my content. Take care, guys. See you next video, and bye-bye.